teaching at Olney and ISD?
Oh, God.
How long have you been teaching, period? 30. Oh, all with Olney? Wow. They must have treated you right. I was a sports kicker operator for Fox Sports Net in the Woodlands for 16 and a half years, and then my job went away about a year and a half ago. So right now, a buddy of mine took the test, and I guess took the training, and became a teacher at Caney Creek High School in Conroe ISD. And I've been subbing a lot for Conroe ISD, and he wants me to join him as a teacher, and it's interesting. My degree was in communications, but it's so long ago, like it's so out of date. It was before that. I graduated in 93, so before that. It's good. Brad Gilmore, that name sounds familiar. Okay. Oh, okay. Was a news director at the small town radio station of KULP in El Campo, 97 to 02. Now here's something that you as a high school teacher would know. In those 5.5 years I was there, roughly once a year there would be a car accident involving a young person where they'd be killed. I did like 5 or 6 of those, and they always were not wearing their seatbelts. Nimitz is the Cougars, right? What is Davis? That's a new school. Falcons. Okay, Davis Falcons. Right. Aldine, y'all are the Mustangs. And then MacArthur's the Generals, which of course he was a general. And what are the other schools? Aldine. Eisenhower, they're the Eagles. Those are the Eagles. World War II. Yeah, well now Nimitz was an admiral. But the other two, you're right. The other two, yeah, Nimitz, Eisenhower, and MacArthur. Of course, Eisenhower was also a president. And then, oh my goodness, all right. Yep, just last names. All right, okay. Pencil's fine for me. Bradley. Medina. Dennis. Mendoza. As a broadcaster at this point, I think I just have to make up last first names. Menez. I hate to do that. But just call them by the last names. Reynolds. Glenn. They do have initials. Santos.
afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Alden Independent School District
and softball contest for today's contest between the visiting Davis Lady Falcons and your home team, Nimitz Lady Coons.
Conducted in accordance with the rules and regulations set forth by the University and the Scholastic League. Throughout tonight's contest, we ask that you, the spectators, enthusiastically participate, cheer, and encourage these hardworking young individuals. Through your positive support of them, as well as their coaches and the officiating crew, you validate and encourage the importance of being involved in extracurricular activities. As a general reminder, Alden Independent School District and its softball complex are alcohol and tobacco free. As we prepare for this contest, we'd like to ask everyone in attendance to please stand and join us in a moment of silence. Consider all of the participants in this evening's event, their well-being, and everyone's safe return home. Thank you. You may be seated. Parents and guardians, your influence on the young participant in tonight's event is greatly appreciated. Whether your child is involved as a performer, trainer, or player, their positive contribution this evening is a direct result of your dedication to their excellence and their resolve to be the nation's best. On behalf of the administrators, teachers, coaches, and all who work tirelessly with your children, we applaud and thank you. At this time, let's meet the players from Davis High School. The reserves tonight are going to be number one, A. Hernandez. Number nine, B. Lazardi.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Aldine Independent School District Softball Complex. I am Paul Daly, and you are watching Vype Media here in North Houston, right near the intersection of Beltway 8 and Interstate 45. We are getting ready for a 14-6A district contest between Aldine Davis High School and Aldine Nimitz High School. Davis in the red and white. Nimitz is in the black and gold and white. Davis will be on the first base side, and Nimitz is on the third base side of the field. The dimensions here at the Aldine Independent School District softball complex are 200 feet down the right field line, the left field line, and straightaway center. The fence is a 7-foot high fence, except at the center field area where it angles up to 10 feet high. Aldine ISD, home to 5 different schools in the Aldine Independent School District. You have Aldine, you have MacArthur, you have Nimitz, you have Eisenhower, and you have Davis. Davis is the newest of the schools, having opened just in the last decade. The other 4 schools have all been around for many, many years.
We'd like to ask everyone in attendance to please rise. Gentlemen, if you would kindly remove your caps.
And we are getting ready for the start of this broadcast. Nimitz will be the home team, and Davis will be the visiting team.
Thank you.
set to start this broadcast. Nimitz, the home team, will be out on the field at first. We'll go over their defense right now. The starting pitcher is JoJo Bilbao. The catcher, Maya Sid. The left side of the infield is Alyssa Rocha at third and Bridget Herrera at short. Over at the right side of the infield at second base, Abigail Ruiz, and the first baseman is Alondra Guzman. The outfield from left to right, Zora McFarland, Stephanie Linzer in center, and Ayana Garcia is in right field.
Catching tonight, number 8, Maya Sid. First in the lineup for the late Falcons, going to be number 5, Barb Rapp.
And now leading off for the Lady Falcons will be Bradley. The catcher is also their leadoff hitter. Again, wind blowing from a little bit from the center field straight in, so it's going to take a real heck of an effort to hit a home run this afternoon. A little bit also from left to right, so if you are going to hit a home run, probably the odds are it would be over the right field fence more than the left field fence. The game is being played in accordance with all University Interscholastic League rules, and we are privileged to be here on Vype Media for you. Paul Daly on the microphone, and our producer and engineer is Jasmine Jones. One count for the leadoff hitter. Davis in the red jerseys with the white numbers and white lettering. Nimitz, gold and black on their jerseys with white numbers and white letters and white pants. Medina is up now after the walk to Bradley. And that pitch gets away, and the runner will move up, and she's going to take two bases as the third baseman, Rocha, strayed way too far from the bag. And that was a two-base wild pitch. Also a mental error on the third baseman there, Rocha, not going back to the bag. There is a bunt attempt back to the screen. And it is a 1-1 count. Bradley hustling after that wild pitch on the first pitch, taking two bags. Pitch is low and in the dirt, and it is 2-1. And so far here in the early going, Bilbo struggling to find the plate. As in eight pitches, she has missed her mark six times. Now make it seven, and scoring a run will be Bradley on another wild pitch. And it is a run in for Davis. 3-1 count. Again, the wind picking up a little bit from left to right. Swinging slap hit attempt, going to go foul, and the count goes full. And that pitch is ball four. And right now, struggling to find the plate a little bit, JoJo Bilbo.
Next batter up for the Lady Falcons is going to be number 70, Z Dennis.
Dennis now coming up to the plate. District 14 includes the five Aldine ISD schools, along with three from Spring ISD, Spring High School, DeCaney, and Westfield. And there is a throw down to second, not going to be in time, and standing up will be Medina. Called strike on the outside corner, and it is 1-1. That pitch is low and in the dirt, and taking third will be Medina. Officially a wild pitch. That is the third wild pitch so far of the inning for Bilbo. Pop up on the right side. And it will be just foul and out of the reach of first baseman Guzman for Nimitz. The second baseman Ruiz also charging over. Alondra Guzman and Abigail Ruiz gave chase, but it was just out of their reach. In a softball field, only 60 feet between the bases, unlike baseball where it's 90. There's a high pop into right field, and it's going to go over the head of the right fielder Garcia. She will then pick it up, and motoring into second base will be the batter. That will be Dennis with the double. And scoring from third will be Medina. So now Mendoza coming to bat. The right fielder Garcia fooled a little bit, came in initially, Ayana Garcia, and then she had to go back out. Now we have a courtesy runner for the pitcher, and that's going to be Lizardi in. Mendoza batting, and that pitch sails wide on the right-hander. 1-0. And there is another high fly ball, and it's going to go in between the second baseman and center fielder, Ruiz and Linzer, and everybody's going to be safe. These last two fly balls probably could have been caught. In fact, they probably both should have been. But they're not errors because they did not touch the gloves before falling to the ground. And now we have time called as Coach Crystal Middleton of the Nimitz Cougars is going out to the circle to try to calm her team down after a little bit of a rough start. Runners at the corners with nobody out and two runs in the top of the first. 2-0 our score. With Nimitz coming to bat in the bottom of the first. Aldine ISD, North Houston. Situated south of Spring and north of Houston ISD. Very close, and I believe Intercontinental Airport is in the Aldine School District boundaries. I may be wrong on that. It's either that or it's Humboldt. No, it is. It is in the Aldine Independent School District boundaries. Taking second base without a throw is going to be Mendoza. The stolen base. So now runners are at second and third. And the count goes to 3-0. And that's ball four in the dirt, and there's going to be a play at the plate. No, diving in safe will be the courtesy runner, Lizardi, and it's 3-0. And moving over to third on the wild pitch is Mendoza, but that... I thought that would have been ball four, but apparently that's just ball three. And so it is 3-1. And now that pitch gets away from the catcher. And another run scores in Mendoza. And going down to first base is Jimenez. And that pitch gets away, and heading down to second base is Jimenez, and it's just a wild pitch fest. That is the unofficially sixth wild pitch of the half inning. Slow roller to first. This should be the very first out of the game, and it is, as Guzman takes it to the plate. And Reynolds is retired, 3 unassisted. And now Glenn coming to the plate for Davis with a runner at third and one out. That pitch in the dirt behind her, but doing a nice job stopping it there is the catcher, Maya Sid. And holding the runner at third, Jimenez. Strike called. Nice pick of it, 2-1. Strike two called on the inner half of the plate. Overcast skies here in Houston. A little bit of sun is kind of peeking out over off to our south, but mostly just white and gray skies. There is a slow roller to third. Picking it, firing it, and in time, the run will score in Jimenez, but Glenn is retired on the ground out to Rocha. So she gets an RBI, and that makes it 5-0. But there are two outs for the number eight hitter, Jones. Strike called on the outside corner for the right-handed hitter. Jones, one of the taller players for Davis, separates her hands on her batting stance. Strike called right down the plate. And it is an 0-2 count. Right-handed pitcher, right-handed hitter. Fighting it off, and the count holds at 0-2. Just saw some baseball players warming up in the field off to our right, so they have the baseball and softball fields right next to each other here at the Aldine ISD Sports Complex. There is a hard shot down the right side, and that's going to get through for a single. Nice bit of two-strike hitting there for Jones.
The next batter is number two, Estella Sago.
Thorne Stadium, which is also on this sports complex campus for Aldine ISD, is undergoing massive renovations and going to be a pretty much a brand-new stadium, I believe, ready in time either for the 2024 season or maybe even this fall in 2023. But Aldine ISD upgrading some facilities with Thorne Stadium. And the Campbell Center, also the basketball facility here, is one of the top-notch facilities in Houston, a very good high school facility. They have the Region 3 Women's 6A tournament here every year, and the men's, the boys' tournament as well. Was here a number of years ago, saw some very good players play here just about 5-6 years ago. Three and oh now to the number nine hitter, De Los Santos, the second baseman. Ball four. And yeah, we're back at the top. Another walk. Going after the first pitch, and it is a single up the middle. Throw home, and unable to hold it is the catcher, Sid, and scoring from second base is Jones. Up a base on the throw home is De Los Santos and Bradley. It's an RBI single for Bradley, and now Medina is up. And it is 6-0 before Nimitz even has a chance to bat. Medina walked, stole a base, and scored earlier this inning. And that pitch gets away from Sid, and scoring from third base is De Los Santos on the wild pitch. As a plane goes overhead. Years ago, when I came here to the Campbell Center to broadcast a high school basketball game, De'Aaron Fox of the Sacramento Kings was playing as a junior in high school at the time, so it was a number of years ago. And that's ball four, and Medina goes to first. Holding it third base is Bradley, and now the number three hitter, Dennis, is back up for the second time. She doubled and scored a run back earlier this inning. Goes after the pitch and grounds it foul up the third base side. In the dirt, heading into second base, without a throw will be Medina. Swing and miss at a changeup. Count those to one and two on the three hitter, Dennis. That ball gets away from the catcher, Sid. Everybody moves up, including a run for Bradley, her second run of the inning. And it's now 8-0. That pitch is in the dirt, getting away, and scoring from third base is Medina. Her second run of the inning and the ninth run here in the top of the first for Benjamin Davis. And there are nobody left on base, and it's a 3-2 count to the number three hitter, the pitcher, Dennis. And there is a pop-up, and the second baseman, Ruiz, makes a nice catch, and the inning is over. And our score after one half inning of play, Davis High School 9 and Nimitz High School coming to bat. You're watching Aldine ISD softball on the Vype Sports. Vype Live at the Aldine Independent School District Softball Complex. Our producer engineer is Jasmine Jones, and we are in here for the duration of this 14-6A district softball game between the Davis Falcons and the Nimitz Cougars. Davis dropped a 9 spot as they sent 12 players to the plate in the top of the first, and Nimitz now is going to have a big hole to climb out of as they're trying to get this 14-6A victory. As I see Aldine High School, the baseball players are warming up over off to my right in center field at the baseball field.
Catching tonight, Bradley.
The defense,
number 4, Jojo Dilma.
4 Davis, Dennis in the circle, Bradley catching. At third base, it is Glenn, the shortstop Mendoza, second baseman De Los Santos, the first baseman Sandin. The outfield from left to right, Reynolds, Medina, and Jones. Dennis, back in the top of the inning, had an RBI double and scored a run, and then popped up to the second baseman, Ruiz, to end the inning. The lineup for Nimitz, Jojo Bilbo leading off, Zora McFarland batting second, Bridget Herrera third. The cleanup hitter is Stephanie Linzer, Alondra Guzman batting fifth, Ayana Garcia sixth, Abigail Ruiz seventh, Alyssa Rocha batting eighth, and the catcher, Maya Sid, batting ninth. Going after the first pitch and lining a solid single into center field is JoJo Bilbo. And now she hustles into second on the outfield miscue. And you have the lead off runner on. Zora McFarland now up, showing bunt. And she takes the pitch low and outside for ball one. Again, showing bunt, the infielder's pinching close in, and she pops it up. And that's going to be an easy out for the first baseman, Sandin, as McFarland popped out for the first out of the inning.
Batter number three, Bridget Herrera.
Bridget Herrera now batting. Kind of a curious decision to bunt after giving up a nine spot in the top of the inning, but we will see. High strike, and it is strike one to Herrera. Again, wind blowing from left to right here, coming in out of the north. Outside, and the count evens at 1-1. Infielders are playing back, fouled off, and the count goes 1-2. Again, the Aldine Independent School District Sports Complex. We have a softball field, baseball field, competition gymnasium, primarily for basketball and volleyball, and also the football stadium. Again, a lot of construction going on here at the football stadium. That's a changeup that sails outside on the right-hand hitter, and the count goes to 2-2. Strike three as Herrera swung through the inside fastball, and it is two down. Stephanie Linzer now batting. And she goes after the first pitch and sky highs it down the right field line, and making a nice catch moving over is the right fielder there, Jones for Davis, and the inning is over. Our score after one, Davis 9 and Nimitz 0. You're watching Vype Live. Softball complex. Paul Daly and Jasmine Jones here for Vype Live. Jasmine, producer, engineer, extraordinaire. 14-6A is the district. Competition between Nimitz and Davis. Davis, 9 runs in the top of the first. Although, again, some miscues and lots of walks and wild pitches contributed.
Back on the mound.
Batter 5 hits, 4 walks, and 9 runs for Davis in the top of the first. It's now 9-0. Again, the first 2 hits by Dennis and Mendoza, a double and a single. Both of them were high fly balls that potentially could have been caught, but the fielders simply just were not able to run underneath. And that opened the floodgates, and sometimes good teams, when you make a mental mistake or physical mistake, they take advantage. And Davis High School absolutely did that in the top of the first. And that will be ball 4. And the cleanup hitter and leadoff hitter this inning, Mendoza, will head down to first base with the walk. And that pitch is in the dirt, gets all the way to the backstop, moving over to second base is Mendoza on the wild pitch. Now batting Jimenez, the designated player for Davis. And that's going to be another wild pitch, and moving over to third base will be Mendoza. Struggling to find the plate here early is Bilbo. Throw over to third, very close. And now we're going to see what the call is. They are going to say she's safe. We have time called. And the umpires are going to meet, along with all the Nimitz infielders. And now they're saying out over at third base. So that is a pickoff. Pickoff 1-5. So Bilbo to Rocha, caught her napping, and Alyssa Rocha applied the tag. Foul tip. And the count 0-2. Or 2-2, excuse me. Full count on Jimenez. And she sky-highs it to right field, and it is going over the head of the right fielder Garcia and up against the fence. She will throw it back in. It'll get away from the cutoff man, Abigail Ruiz, but Bilbo is backing her up, and that will be a double for Jimenez. All right, and we have a substitution as the right fielder, Ayana Garcia, is coming out of the ball game. We're going to try to get the number out there. We will try to get the information from the home plate umpire, and unfortunately, not putting it through. We'll get that number in a little bit. T. Reynolds is up. Swing and a miss. And hustling back into second base is Jimenez. Reynolds, a lefty, takes a strike on the outer third of the plate. That was an off-speed pitch, and it is 0-2. Swing and a miss. And down on strikes is T. Reynolds. First strikeout of the game for Bilbo. Glenn is up. A big cut and a miss. There are two outs. That pitch is low, and it is and evens the count at 1-1. Mendoza was picked off third earlier in the inning. Jimenez then doubled, and now Reynolds struck out. And there's another strike, 1-2. So after a rough first inning, JoJo Bilbo kind of finding a little bit of a rhythm here in the second to this point. 1-2 count with two away. And there is a grounder up the middle. And Bilbo takes care of it to first and Guzman. And after 1.5, the score remains Davis 9 and Nimitz 0. You are watching Aldean ISD softball on Vype Live. Watching Aldean ISD softball on Vype Live. Paul Daly and Jasmine Jones here for Vype Media. And Davis High School for Aldean just burst out in the top of the first inning and plated 9 runs. 5 hits, 4 walks. Some misplayed fly balls and a whole lot of wild pitches, and they scored a 9 spot. And Nimitz High School has their work cut out for them to try to come back in this ball game here in the bottom of the second inning. It's going to be the 5-6-7 hitters, Alondra Guzman, Ayana Garcia, and Abigail Ruiz coming up for Nimitz. In the black, gold, and white. Davis in red and white. It's a nice day for softball. A little bit overcast here in Houston. The lights have been on ever since the start of this ball game at 5 o'clock. Swing and a miss. So there will not be really any shadows to deal with at all, since it's not really a sunny day anyway, and the lights have been on since the beginning. But the wind has died down a little bit. Was blowing out of the north and pretty strongly earlier, but it's not really blowing at this moment. Pitch goes into the dirt, 1-1 count. Outfielders playing pretty deep. in straightaway center for Davis. That is Medina out in straight center field. The corner outfielders, Reynolds in left and Jones in right, are playing a little bit more shallow. This is Alondra Guzman, the first baseman, batting right now for Nimitz with a 2-1 count. And make it 3-1. That's ball four, high and inside, and Nimitz has the leadoff batter on. Ayana Garcia. No, this is the new hitter. We will check that number in just a second. Toss down to first, not in time.
Number six, Ayana Richards is going to be back.
Alana Richards is the new batter. She is now in right field wearing the number six. She entered in the top of the second. One count. Strike call.
One ball, two strikes.
At the letters, a high strike right there. The umpires are courtesy of the Texas Association of Sports Officials. Slow roller to first, to the pitcher, excuse me, and going on to shortstop in time to get the lead runner. That is Dennis to Mendoza. And settling in at first on the fielder's choice is Richards. So Dennis does a good job, throw down on the stolen base attempt, not going to be in time. And Richards takes second base. Abigail Ruiz is now up to bat. She is the second baseman wearing the number one. Strike called, and the count evens at one apiece. If you are watching us today from outside of the Houston area, and you're wondering where Aldine ISD is, it is just south of Beltway 8 in Houston, pretty close to Interstate 45, about 3-4 miles to our west. Strike called in 1-2, Aldine ISD. Number of very good athletic teams over the years. Aldine High School, grounder hard up the middle, and I think everyone's going to be safe there. And now there's going to be a play at the plate, out at the plate, as trying to go all the way from second on the infield single was Richards, and she is thrown out. Good job that time by Dennis to Bradley. And they erase the lead runner. Alyssa Rocha now batting. With a runner at first. And two away. As I was saying just a moment ago, Aldine ISD has had some very good sports programs here over the years. The Aldine High football team was state runner-up in 1989, state champions of the largest school classification in 1990, and then they made the semifinals in 91. Also, Eisenhower High School has had a number of good football teams over the years that made a lot of deep playoff runs back in the 90s and early 2000s. Also some very good boys basketball teams out of Aldine ISD over the years. That pitch is high, and the throw down is going to get away from the first baseman, Sandin. And going all the way to third will be Ruiz. On the errant throw by the catcher. And she now is at third with two away. 2-0 the count for the third baseman, Alyssa Rocha. Strike called, and it now goes to 2-1. And there is a grounder into the hole at short, and she is going to beat it out, and a run will score for Nimitz. Not in time at second base. And Rocha with an RBI single and a move up on the errant throw. And Nimitz has their first run of the game. Now the catcher, Maya Sid, comes up to the plate with two down. Sid wearing the number 8. In the black, gold, and white. And she takes the first pitch fastball from Dennis up and in. Wind picking up a little bit now, again blowing pretty much from left to right, almost straight in out of the north. Swing and a miss, and the count goes to 1-1. Swing and a miss, 9-1 our score here in the bottom of the second inning. And I may need to get my eyes checked. It's navy and gold. So it's actually the colors of the Naval Academy, navy and gold, navy blue. And slapping foul just over the Davis dugout. And the count will hold. Nimitz. Kind of appropriate that it is that is navy blue, since it's named after Navy Admiral Chester Nimitz, who was from Texas originally and was a 5-star admiral in World War II. If anyone had seen the Midway movie that came out a few years ago, Woody Harrelson played him. Swing and a miss over the top, and that will end the second inning. But Nimitz plates their first run of the game. Abigail Ruiz scores on the RBI single by Alyssa Rocha, and it's 9-1 after two, and you are watching Aldine ISD softball on Vype Live. Vype Live presents Aldine ISD softball. It is Davis High School against Nimitz High School. The Davis Falcons and the Nimitz Cougars, and our score after two innings of play. It is 9-1, Falcons leading the Cougars. So it was a top of the first to remember for Davis, as they scored 9 times on 5 hits, 4 walks. I think the grand total was 8 wild pitches and some fielding miscues. And they have maintained that lead. Nimitz did played a run in the bottom of the second on an RBI single, and that's where we stand at 9-1. JoJo Bilbo still in the circle for Nimitz. And due up this inning for Davis. They're 8-9-1 hitters. Jay Jones, Estelos Santos, and R. Bradley. Jones and Delos Santos and Bradley all scored runs back in the first inning. In fact, Bradley scored twice. Jones is the right fielder. She made a nice running catch to end the bottom of the first inning off the bat of Stephanie Linzer there in the right field corner. And the patient batter, Jones, has watched three pitches go wide and high, and she is in a favorable count, 3-0. And she fouls it off to the right side. Back in the first inning, Jones hit it the other way, had the sharp single into right field, and later scored on an RBI single by Bradley. Just a bit outside, and taking first base will be Jones.
Up next to bat, wearing the number 2, is going to be De La Santos.
The number 9 hitter, Estelos Santos, is up. She is the second baseman. She singled and scored on a wild pitch back in the first inning. And now we may have a pinch hitter coming up. A. Hernandez, number 1, is going to come up for De Los Santos.
De Los Santos is
going to
be exchanged for A. Hernandez, wearing the number 1.
And Hernandez is up. That pitch gets away from the catcher, Sid, and heading into second base easily is Jones. Again, JoJo Bilbo struggling to find the plate so far here in this ball game, as she has had multiple wild pitches. We lost track, frankly. The right-hander delivers outside, and it's now 3-0. Struggling to find the plate. Control has been a major issue. Strike called right down Broadway, and it is 3-1. Or maybe since we're here at Aldine, I should say right down Aldine Bender. Broadway in Houston is near Hobby Airport, and we're on the north side, much closer to Bush Intercontinental. Ball 4, and taking first base is Hernandez. So back-to-back walks here to start the third. And we are getting a new pitcher coming in. So Bilbo is going out.
And Jay Brooks takes him out for the lady.
Brooks is coming in. So Jay Brooks is now in.
Jay
And we will take a timeout here in the top of the third. Runners at first and second with nobody out in a pitching change. You're watching Aldine ISD softball on Vype. Aldine ISD softball on Vype Live. Our score in the top of the third inning, 9-1. Benjamin O. Davis High School leads Chester Nimitz High School. The Falcons over the Cougars here in the third inning, 9-1.
We have a catcher change. Number one, Abigail Ruiz.
And a new catcher. Is going to be Abigail Ruiz. So we've had some changes. And JoJo Bilbo has gone to second. And there is a line single in the left, and it bounces off the left fielder McFarland. And that's going to be an error. And coming in to score from second base is number 14, Jones, on the RBI single by Bradley. Everybody moves up a base on the throw home. Technically an RBI because Jones did not hesitate at all coming around third, even though the ball did get away momentarily from McFarland. And moving up a base on the throw home will be Hernandez at third and Bradley at second. That pitch just inside, gets away momentarily, and coming in to score will be Hernandez. And now coming in to score a second run will be Bradley, as everybody has fallen asleep at the wheel there. And that now makes it 12-1, and still batting with nobody else is D. Medina. Way outside. And the count goes to 3-0. And that hits the batter, hit pit by pitch, and Medina goes down to first base. It was a changeup that just rode inside on the left-hand hitter. And one area that Nimitz has been struggling, whether it's been Bilbo or now Brooks on in the circle, is they are really struggling to find the plate. Way high, taking off, gonna make it the second, and now going all the way to third, trying to, and she'll hustle back in, is gonna be Medina. She took off with the pitch anyway, so it counts as a stolen base. Nearly tried to make it to third, but the catcher, Abigail Ruiz, caught it in time after the pitch got away and threw down to third to Rocha to put her back. And she'll head to third with that wild pitch, so it delayed the inevitable, I suppose. And it's now runner at third with nobody out here, top of the third. upstairs, and now a throw down, and that's going to be an errant throw, and coming in to score is Medina. On the throw by the catcher, Ruiz. And it's 13-1. The wind has ceased as the planes fly overhead near Bush Intercontinental Airport. Aldine ISD softball, ball four, and the starting pitcher, Dennis, is going to head down to first. So the new pitcher, Brooks, has come in, faced three batters, given up an RBI single, a hit by pitch, and a walk. Three plate appearances is the more accurate way to state that. That pitch sails high. 2-0 to the cleanup hitter, Mendoza, the shortstop. Three and oh the count as Brooks continues to struggle to find the plate. Ball four, and runners are at first and second.
The next batter for the Lady Falcons is going to be number seven, Kenny Jimenez.
Kay Jimenez coming to the plate for Benjamin O. Davis High School, the Falcons in the red and white. Benjamin Davis, Jr., a United States Air Force general and commander of the World War II Tuskegee Airmen. He was the first brigadier general in the United States Air Force who was African American. He was a four-star general back in the 1990s. So other than Aldine High School, the other four high schools in Aldine ISD all named after military leaders. Three generals and an admiral. Runners at first and second with nobody out. 3-1 count now to Kay Jimenez, and it's going to be ball four. And we have a new hitter, Lizardi, coming in. In the top of the third. So Lizardi on with the bases loaded and nobody out in a 13-1 game. Top of the third. Come on, Paul Daly and Jasmine Jones here for Vype Live. You're watching 14-6A softball, Aldine ISD. Overcast April day here in Greater Houston. 1 week ago today, the University of Connecticut won their fifth men's basketball championship about 25 miles from here at NRG Stadium. Houston will also be hosting the College Football National Championship coming up next January of 24. Strike called, 3-1. So a lot of big events coming to Houston area. We had the Final Four this year for the first time in 7 years. Had it back in 2016 and now again in 2023. Ball four. And the bases loaded walk for Lizardi is an RBI and scores a run from third. That is Dennis. Everybody else moves up 60 feet. Mendoza to third, Jimenez to second, and Lizardi settles in at first base. And now Coach Crystal Middleston of the Nimitz Cougars coming over to talk to the home plate umpire to make some changes. And leaving the circle will be Jay Brooks. And we're going to see who's going to be the new pitcher for Nimitz. They have a whole bunch of moving parts at this point. New outfielders everywhere. The new pitcher is number 14, Zora McFarland. And the catcher is now going to be back to Maya Sid. Our score, Davis High School 14, Nimitz High School 1. We are in the top of the third inning for a pitching change. We will take a quick break. You're watching Aldine ISD softball on Vype Live.
Come on.
It's Chester Nimitz High School, 14-1. Bases loaded, nobody out. Brand new pitcher, Zora McFarland. And dead ball. She hits the first batter she faces. And that is L. Glenn, hit by pitch. And that is an RBI. And scoring from third will be Mendoza. Jimenez to third and Lizardi to second. Strike called on the inside corner to Jay Jones. She, in two plate appearances, has a single and a walk and has scored two runs for the Falcons. Softball became a UIL sport back in the early 90s, say 1992, 93, 94, somewhere in there. Strike called. Back in the early days of softball as a UIL sport. Dobie High School out of Pasadena ISD here in the Houston area won a couple of state championships with a young woman named Krista Williams, who later would go pitch for the University of Texas and pitch in the Olympics. I believe she is now a high school coach. Dead ball with another hit batter at Channelview High School last time I heard. So Jones, in three plate appearances, has reached base safely three times. And scoring on the hit batter is Jimenez. Alexa Hernandez coming to the plate. In a 16-1 ball game, make it 17-1. On and again, another hit batter. That is three in a row for Nimitz pitching. The last one was by Brooks. The first one was by Brooks. The last two were by McFarland. And that's going to be it for Zora McFarland, as they're putting her back in the outfield. So Bilbo coming back in, the starter. And since she was already out playing, they're not going to say that she needs warm-up pitches. There is a line drive, base hit over the shortstop Herrera's head, going all the way close to the wall. One run scores, two runs scores. Moderate depth, left center field, and an excellent bit of hitting right there by the leadoff hitter, Bradley. She is now 3-for-3 with a walk. That is a double and two RBI. Glenn and Jones were to score, and going all the way to third base is Hernandez, and that makes it 19-1. That pitch is in the dirt, gets away, and everybody is safe. One run scores, now the wild errant throw, and two runs score. And just like that, Hernandez and Bradley are in, and it's now 21-1 here in the top of the third. And there is a slow roller to short. not in time. Beating it out is Medina. And D. Medina, the left-hand hitter, slapped it over to short, and playing very deep is Bridget Herrera, and she came up and made the clean play, the clean throw, but she was just playing too deep to get the speedy Medina. In this inning, that pitch gets away, heading to second base for a stolen base is Medina. Now she's going to try to take third on the wild pitch, and she will. This is the 14th batter of the inning, Dennis. 12 have scored, and Medina is at third base. There's still nobody out. They have had three pitching changes in this inning already for Nimitz. And that's going to be low and inside. And it's now 22-1 on another wild pitch. Coming in to score is Medina. So Bilbo will settle back in, and Dennis, slow roller to third, picked cleanly, and oh, dropping it over there at first base is Alondra Guzman as Roach's throw is a little bit wide, and that's going to be an E5. When it rains, it pours, and right there, if you're Nimitz, you needed something good to happen. You got the ground ball to third. You did not have a fast runner running. You got to make that play. Wild pitch, and going to second is the pitcher, Dennis. Ball two. Three and oh. Hard shot to short, picked on the first in time. And a little bit of a bobble there by Herrera, but she had the strong enough arm to get away with it. And Mendoza is retired for the first out of the inning. Going over to third base is Dennis. Kay Jimenez, the designated player, is hitting. She goes after the first pitch, pops it foul, and just out of the reach of the first baseman, Alondra Guzman. Jimenez is officially 1-for-1 with a double, two walks, and two runs scored. Dead ball as she is hit. She will head down to first base, so you have runners at the corners with one out. Lizardi now back to hit for her second time today to the plate. She is 0-for-0 with a walk in her first plate appearance. Strike called. She does have a run scored. She replaced T. Reynolds, the left fielder, at the plate back in the top of the third inning. Pitch is low, count goes to 2-1. Monday afternoon softball. Again, a lot of these games were moved around because of very inclement weather last week. We had rain Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and even some Saturday. Taking second base is Kay Jimenez on the fielder's indifference. Strike called on the outside half of the plate, and the count goes full. 3-2 with one out. Lizardi settles in. Ball four, and she will take her base on the walk. Seven walks. Three hit by pitch. Four hit by pitch. Three hits and an error have plated 13 runs. There's a slow roller to third. And everybody's going to be safe. Rocha tried to go back to the shortstop, Herrera, who was covering at third. She was behind the runner. At that point, Rocha really needed to make the decision just to throw it across the infield. And another run will score Dennis from third. Jimenez is on at third, Lizardi is at second, and Glenn is at first. And we have a balk called, illegal pitch, and everybody moves up, and a run scores. If the runner left the bag early, that would be an out, and there'd be two outs, and the run would not count. And you would have runners back at first and second, which I guess is what they're saying happened.
One ball.
So they are saying two outs. So Jimenez did not score on that earlier play. Wild pitch moves up the runners. There is a slow roller to the circle and a nice play over at first base. Bilbo to Guzman, and we are out of the inning. On the ground out by Jones for the third out. And our score after two and a half innings, 23-1 after the 14 runs in the third inning. You're watching Vype Live, and we are at the Aldine Independent School District softball field on their sports complex. At 1865 Aldine Bender Road.
Once the bat for the Lady Coons, you can be number four, Julio Bilbo.
And the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the third inning, JoJo Bilbo, followed by Zora McFarland and Bridget Herrera, 1-2-3 in a 23-1 ball game. Strike call on the off-speed pitch. Bilbo 1-for-1. She had a leadoff single back in the first inning and was stranded at second base. Swing and a miss at a tailing fastball, and it's quickly 0-2. Bouncing it up there, trying to get her to chase, is Dennis. Bilbo would not, and it's a 1-2 count. Nimitz High School, the alma mater of WNBA star Brittany Griner. Swing and a miss. First out here in the bottom of the third inning. Nimitz, their girls basketball team, made it all the way to the state final, Griner's senior year, where they were upset before she went on to an All-American career at Baylor and now in the WNBA. That pitch sails high and away, and it is 1-0. Swing and a miss at a rising fastball, and the count evens at 1. Ball skips between the legs of the catcher Bradley, and the count goes to 2-1. As we will take a few seconds to clean off home plate. A little bit of a breezy, cool April day here in Houston. Wind blowing in straight from center field. Swing and a miss. Little bit left to right, but mostly just in. It's going to be very hard for anybody to hit a home run today with the wind blowing in. Up and in, and the count goes full on Zora McFarland, who started the game in left, later came on to pitch briefly, and then went back to left. She takes a walk.
McFarland advances to first. Up makes the bat. Very number three, Bridget Herrera.
Tailing in for a 1-0 count now to Bridget Herrera. 0-for-1 with a strikeout back in the first inning. And now that pitch is going to get away from Bradley, and moving up to second base will be McFarland. Thank you. Strike called at the knees, and it's a 2-1 count. As the plane flies overhead, that's one of the things that's interesting. If you're at sporting events, either at Aldine ISD or Humble ISD, you will hear those planes going over. Strike called.
Two balls, two strikes.
Depending on which way, Aldine ISD, just the softball complex here, a little bit south of Intercontinental. The Humble ISD football stadium, I know, is a little bit to the east. We got a full count now for Bridget Herrera. Ball four. So back-to-back walks issued by Dennis. And Stephanie Linzer now comes up to bat. And the Davis infield will come to the circle. Glenn Mendoza, De Los Santos, Sandin, and Bradley to discuss any of the defensive assignments here with runners at first and second and only one out. With the starting pitcher, Dennis. Two on and one out for Stephanie Linzer. Strike called on the right-handed hitting center fielder. The outfielders are deep and straight away, and there is a humpback liner to the right side and foul, and the count goes 0-2. Linzer, a high fly ball down to fairly deep right field. That Ayana Garcia made a nice running catch on. That pitch is low. Pardon me, not Garcia, but Jones of Davis made a nice running catch. She now is playing very close to the line, so very large power alleys in left center and right center. Foul tip. Everyone's going to stay where they're at. The catcher, Bradley, not quite able to hold it. Strike three called on the changeup, and Linzer is frozen. Second out of the inning. And now Alondra Guzman is up to the plate. Guzman walked in her only previous plate appearance, and she slaps it foul on the very first offering she sees from Dennis, and it's 0-1. Strike called, and the count evens at 1-1 on the first baseman, Guzman. Throw down to third, not in time as the pitch gets away from the catcher Bradley, and the runners McFarland and Herrera move up a base. Two with two outs. And there is a high pop going down the left side and will be foul ball.
Everybody converged. No one was quite able to catch it. McFarland was the closest, the left fielder, but... Excuse me, not McFarland. Reynolds was the closest. That was Jones. Full count now. To Alondra Guzman, runners on second and third. Foul tip, and she will stay alive at 3-2 with two away. One more pitch could end the inning. Or the wrong pitch could be a two-run hit. Ball four outside, and the bases are loaded. McFarland at third, Herrera at second, and Guzman at first, and it is... Bases loaded with two outs for the Nimitz Cougars. Ayana Garcia is back to bat. Garcia reached on a fielder's choice and now has slapped a single into right field. Two runs will score. And it's 23-3. Ayana Garcia with a single and two RBI. Settling in at second base is Guzman, and it is 23-3. Now batting. Number one, Abigail Ruiz. And foul ball up the right side on the ground. And the count evens at 1-1. Lots of encouragement from the Nimitz bench. As Ruiz fouls it off to the left side this time, the count goes to 1-2. Lots of encouragement for Abigail Abby Ruiz. Drop low and the count goes to 2-2. Strike called on the check swing by Ruiz, and the inning is over. Two runs on one hit.
Two walks, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be the ball game.
And our score,
remember,
23-3.
No matter how far
that
you have
will
to
be
travel,
the final.
Be safe on your journey home.
So. We would like to thank you all for watching this ball game with us on Vype Live. My name is Paul Daly. I want to thank Jasmine Jones, our producer engineer, and all the folks at Vype Media in Austin and Houston for this broadcast and the fine people here at the Aldean Independent School District. Once again, our final score, Benjamin Davis, Falcons 23 and the Chester Nimitz Cougars 3 in this 14-6A district softball game. Good evening from Houston for Vype Live.